Hey there, I'm a hardcore action figure collector, and I only want my toys to shoot real bullets right through the heads of all the villains. It would take something incomparably cute to melt the heart of mine, and I... Well, that actually is pretty cute, but my heart won't be thawed. I need something even more adorable than that. I don't know if such a thing exists in this world, and I...
Back to Anything Jokes, a collaborative journey through the world of G.I. Joe. My name is Greg Engel, and today we're looking at something a little different. Symbiote Studios just released two and a half plush toys as part of their new assortment, and we have both of them to check out right now. The first one that we have is the Cobra Commander, and we're going to crack him open right away and get right into it. This Cobra Commander measures 12 inches tall. You can see that they have the G.I. Joe branding. It is an official Hasbro partnership. And we're going to break them out. Okay, so fresh out of the bag, you can see that this Cobra Commander is reminiscent of version 1 Cobra Commander. He has the light blue color scheme and the face mask. He's got the old stripe that I always like. Oh, there's some C4 under there. Nah, gotcha. He's got his, a lot of little details that you would notice from this figure. Here's the original belt buckle with the triangle shape. He's got the Cobra logo. He's got a little holster, even though there's no, like, knife or gun or anything attached to that. He has his old school cape, which is not typical of the version 1 figure. This is more reminiscent of the... Cobra Commander and G.I. Joe the movie, for example, or maybe more recently the Cobra Commander Classified Deluxe version has a cape that's similar to this. It's like a dark blue on this side but a red on underneath. This is really good material. They list it on the site as high quality soft minky fabric. I don't know if that means that this is made from a mink or maybe just a mink-like material. But I like these a lot. They're a little bit larger than they look like they are on the website, so I was pretty pleased with that. It also comes with a little, let me see if I can get a good shot of that. There's a little pin that's included with this, which I thought was really cool. And then just the official logo branding. So, all in all, this is a pretty great figure. This retails for $24.99. The Snake Eyes figure retails for $29.99 because he comes with a small, I was going to say accessory, but that's pretty rude, to Timber. He comes with his pet Timber. I don't know why I keep petting him like this. Maybe it's the mink fur. Let's take a look at Snake Eyes now. So, same deal with this Snake Eyes classic G.I. Joe branding in the bag. This Snake Eyes also measures at 12 inches tall and has similar vibes. This is obviously the version 2 Snake Eyes based on the battle mask. He's got little, like, I was going to say knobs, but I don't know what these are, like the sides of his visors. You can see that he has the grenades on his bandolier, his regular belt, straps, floppy legs. Same quality fabric, real soft. Feels a little bit more durable than I guess I was going to expect it to be. And he comes with a cool little pin also, which I'll show right there. Which I really like. It's a very minimalistic style. It's a good accessory. Just one of those things that, like the many things that I have in my collection that, you know, I'll find something for it. It's not, I don't have a lot of stuff like that, so I think it's pretty cool. So, again, this is a pretty straightforward, you know, it's got a lot of good stitching on it. I think the detail on this is very well done, and I like it a lot, but even more than that, maybe, I like that he comes with this little guy. So the Snake Eyes is $29.99, but and that is obviously because he has a pet and it's a little Timber. Even the eyes on this are like a felt, but the nose itself is kind of a hard plastic that you would see on toys like these. I really only bring that up because as someone that has a young child in their home, if you were buying these for your kids, you might want to be a little bit careful about that. That's a choking hazard if it was to become, you know, detached. You know your kids better than mine, but I have to be careful what my kid gets in her hands because everything in my house is a choking hazard. But I still feel, you know, overall, the other two figures especially are something that I think that she would enjoy playing with a lot. And I like having them as display pieces as well. I don't want to get too into the nitty-gritty with that, but I like the... I like having stuff like this in my collection because it's unusual and it's unique and it adds a little bit of like flavor to your collection, which I think is pretty cool. Let's take a little bit, I'll take a little bit more of some close-up shots of that, but that's the gist of it. There's only so much you can talk about on a fabric-based plush toy, but I do think that these are high quality. They're not like some cheap knockoff that you would see, you know, at a Walmart or whatever. They were much larger than they're pictured on the website. I was not expecting them to be quite this size, and I'm extremely happy with that. So overall, if this is something that you're interested in, I 100% recommend it. I think they did a really good job with it. I think the stitch work is really good. There's no loose threading. The fabric is quality. And I think that they're pretty great. And that's it. Short and sweet and to the point. Thanks so much for joining us today, and I look forward to seeing you in our next video.